Welcome to my class. In this class, we will learn about single user and multi users operating system. There are different types of operating systems. The complexity level of operating system may vary according to, first, the number of users supported, second, the processing time required, and the third one is availability of technology. On the basis of these three factors, we can determine the complexity level of operating system. All operating systems can be classified as depicted in the following diagram. On the basis of number of users supported and on the basis of CPU utilization. On the basis of number of users supported, we have two types of operating systems. The first one, single user operating system, and the second one, multi-user operating system. On the basis of CPU utilization, we have multitasking operating system, multi-programming operating system, multi-processing operating system, real-time operating system, and uniprogramming operating system. In this class, we will have a focus on single user operating system and multi-user operating system. On the basis of number of users supported, we have two types of operating system, single user operating system and multi-users operating system. The operating system for those computers, mainly microcomputers, which support only one computer, and that is standalone PC. The PC which is not connected to any other computer. Examples of single user operating systems are MS-DOS, PC-DOS. These two are very popular operating system for single users. MS-DOS is from Microsoft and PC-DOS is from IBM. Personal Computer Disk Operating System. On this particular computer, there is one operating system and this computer is not connected to any other computer. This computer has its own operating system and that operating system allows this computer to function. This is computer 1, this is computer 2. Computer 1 has operating system and computer 2 does not have any operating system. The operating system of computer number 1, it will not help computer number 2 to operate. So the operating system which assists only in operating one computer, that particular operating system is termed as single user operating system. Now the second category is multi-user operating system. The operating system used for those computers, micro to mainframe, which have many terminals attached and they support number of users. It means there is one computer which is having operating system, but it assists other computers to run with the same operating system. Examples of multi-user operating systems are Unix, Xenix, Windows NT, OS2, Linux. All these are examples of multi-user operating system. We can understand with the help of one particular example that how does this multi-user operating system assist each other. This is computer number 1. It has its own operating system. But computer number 2, it does not have any operating system. Similarly, computer number 3, it does not have any operating system. Finally, computer 4, again, it does not have any operating system. So we have operating system only in computer 1, and in the other 3 computers, there is no operating system program. What we can do is that computer number 1 can be connected to computer number 2, computer number 4, computer number 3. Computer number 1 can be connected to all the three computers, and the operating system in computer 1 can start helping computer 2, it can start helping computer 3, it can help computer 4 to start functioning. It means operating system is only on one particular computer, but it helps other computers in which there is no operating system program, but still they can be run, they can be managed, they can be controlled by operating system of computer number 1. This is the case of multi-user operating system. Thank you very much.